Is dairy safe for over-methylators?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Anita Morgan says, if your body produces too much methy, I think that might be methyl, meaning methyl groups, how much methylcobalamin in dairy is safe? Should you switch from cow's milk to goat? There's so little methylcobalamin in milk that I think that it is totally insignificant with regards to methyl groups coming into the methylation cycle. I have a video why I don't believe in over-methylators and under-methylators. Generally, if you're experiencing over-methylation symptoms from methylcobalamin or methylfolate, I think the big issue is partly that you don't have enough glycine in the system, very likely, and partly that your body is over-accustomed to low methyl supply, and putting more suddenly into it is leading to the system being adapted to a different state than the one you're putting into it. And so titrating methylated supplements up slowly, I think, is the way to deal with that. So glycine titration up slow doses. But methylcobalamin in dairy is like generally the methyl groups in methylated supplements should be nowhere near significant in terms of methyl flux. But for people in whom they are significant based on how they react to the supplements, even still, there's, you know, from methylcobalamin from dairy, you're talking about very low microgram levels. You know, sub microgram levels. And so this is orders of magnitude different from a high dose supplement. I just can't imagine that there can be a rule of cow milk has too much methylcobalamin. I would look first at restoring balance with glycine and titrating up methylated supplements slowly. But I would be very surprised if dairy was an issue like that. But if you find it is, you're reacting to dairy, I would be very surprised if it was the methylcobalamin. But if you're very convinced of that, then titrate up slowly with the dairy. But that would surprise me. Thank you, Anita, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Master Pass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Master Pass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.